Hey, I'm Daryl Cagle, and today I'm going to be doing yet another Donald Trump cartoon. And thank you for joining me, and let's just make it happen. So, this is what I've got on the screen in front of me. Wedding picture. So today's drawing is going to be a wedding drawing with Donald Trump getting bride and groom with the Republican elephant bride, and she's crying. And Donald Trump says women always cry at weddings. So that is the drawing. I think I'm going to I think I need a kind of a tight in view on the couple to get it to be wide enough. And not quite sure how to handle a veil on the elephant. We'll have to think about that. Where's the gag go? It reads from left to right. So, let's see if we can get this to work. So, I'm going to have... Let's move that down a little bit. All right. Still my microphone. All right, now I'm ready to go. So thank you folks for joining me. Thank you, Akomi. All right. So I have no thumbnail to start with. I'm starting from scratch. All of this reluctant Republicans with Trump is just wonderful fun. So, how do I lay this out? Let's do it on a post-it note first. Yeah, Akomi, I have not given up on you, of course, of course. So, layout, I think I'm going to have Trump here. At that kind of size. Crying elephant. Maybe they need to go down a little bit more like that. So there's Trump. I'm sorry, I'm distracted by all these other things. I didn't go through my usual setup process today. Too many things to set up. So she's here. And she's bawling. She's got her bouquet. They do for fails. I want her to be fairly small next to Trump. Maybe she needs to come down here and have a speech balloon there. Okay, let's give that a try. Paste that up in front of me. So here's Trump. Thank you. people have been telling me that I need to color Trump differently and emphasize the the white areas around his eyes where he seems to wear his goggles that keep that area clear from his spray tan. This is an off the top of my head Trump. Don't think I'm quite to the point where I draw him with no photoscrap. Okay, he says, women always cry at weddings. I think I was going to have him say, "The women always cry at weddings," because that's kind of funny. But I asked around and other people didn't think that was so funny. They said, "Why does he say the women?" All right, women. I like his posture, where he hangs back and the head kind of just rolls forward out of the shoulders. I'll be drawing this quite a while. So is chat working, everybody? I think I'm having some chat problems. It might be working. Somebody respond. Okay. So there's Trump. Comments ain't moving. Ah, I think that worked, Comey. I think it's working. thanks for your response. Don't think we have many people watching here. Okay, her nose is going to go down that way, so maybe her mouth should come back that way. Let's move her over here. She can have her bouquet here. What do we want to do with her eyes? I think Trump's looking okay. That's the Trump out of my head. He's not fading like they're supposed to in the stream. I guess it doesn't matter if I, hello, David Diddle 24. Okay. Well, I can move that down. I guess that's okay. I don't really have to fade. They can just stay there. They changed the font too. I went back to lose my settings, I think. Ah, that's good enough. Anyway, David Diddle 24, you're Trump man. You should follow me. I'm gonna be drawing a whole lot of Trump in the days to come. Alright, what do I want to make her face look like? Kind of stumping. David Diddle writes, are you a Trump supporter or are you just drawing him for fun? I'm a political cartoonist. I draw Trump whether I support him or not. And I think it's kind of my role not to like everybody. If I like somebody, I'm not doing a good job as a political cartoonist. And I wouldn't say that I like Trump, but I'd say that I'm probably the least anti-Trump of all the editorial cartoonists I can think of. And I'm going to vote for Trump over Hillary because I think Hillary is just too eager to get us into wars, and I'm kind of a one-issue voter. You know, the neocons do a lot of complaining about Trump, and their biggest complaint that I hear is that he's an isolationist, and I like that. I want him to be an isolationist, and I think that Hillary is just too eager to jump into Iraq and Libya, and I'm a one-issue voter there. I will vote for Trump, although I will not say that I support anybody. All right. I think I need to go with the most cryable. That means the bottom lip goes up, and the nose should, the trunk should go that way. That's what it should be, huh? And then she needs hair, and then this stuff. Yeah, that's what she's got to have. So David Diddle 24 writes, I hate Hillary Clinton, or as Trump says, crooked Hillary. I don't hate Hillary, but I think that she is too much of a hawk for me. And I don't like all these stories that I hear of her being the voice in the Obama administration of wanting to jump into the conflicts. So I'm with all the people that are the vote against somebody this year. For me, I'll be voting against Hillary, but actually both of them are good for cartoonists. Trump and Hillary, both gifts to cartoonists. Another thing I like about Trump, in particular to the Republican field, is I like that he is not religious. And I am fearful of characters like Ted Cruz or Mike Huckabee that have this religious worldview of wanting to bring on the apocalypse and fiddle around in the Middle East and support Israel for the purpose of being on the right side of the apocalypse. I don't mind Israel per se, but the fact that all of their support comes from these far-right evangelical Protestants who just want to be on the right side of the apocalypse and expect everybody in Israel to be dead with the apocalypse, that seems like that should not be the kind of supporters that Israel wants to count on. That's what you get from a Ted Cruz. But Ted Cruz is gone, and David Dill 24 writes, if I was 1 year older, I'd vote for Trump over Hillary. You have to be a year older to vote, David Idle 24, because I thought you were 24. Okomi writes, which Middle Eastern country do you think Hillary will invade first? Oh, I don't know. It looks like we're already in plenty of Middle Eastern countries. Okay, so here is her crying mouth. I may need to pull the speech balloon up tighter or make it higher. I really hadn't thought this through, but what's a puzzle with this stuff is that you gotta... Gotta pull the faces in tight. David Diddle 24 writes, I'm 17, IDK, where the 24 in my username comes from. You call me David. All right, David, you need to follow me. I'm hurting for followers. 17's a good thing to be. Are you in high school, David? Do you ever study my cartoons in high school? You know, editorial cartoons are part of state-mandated testing in 8th and 11th grade. And you should be taking an American history class or American government class that covers editorial cartoons. And very often, it's my cartoons that they cover. Oh, thank you, David Doe, for following. I appreciate that. You're an older follower. I can tell right now that I'm going to be fiddling around with this crying elephant for a while. Funny, I drew a Trump that I'm kind of satisfied with fairly quickly. And what would be easier is the elephant, and I'm not finding her easier right now. Maybe she should be looking away. Ah, finishing up 11th grade and see lots of political cartoons in your U.S. history class. Well, good. They should be showing you my cartoons. I kind of need that crossed business to make sense. I think. Needed more of that mouth direction, didn't it? Okay. This doesn't have to, I mean, her trunk can go in front of Trump. Let's do that for here. I have to give Trump his boutonniere. That's wrong. I had it right before. Yeah, kind of slow and struggling with what should be an awfully easy cartoon. That's not bad. I think she's going to need some lipstick. Let's do that. Yeah, you know, I think the problem that I was having before was that her, looking at her straight on, I didn't get enough of the perspective to have her mouth open that I think it needed. So I'm going to look. This is what I'm looking at. And, it's always interesting to see the other cartoons to see how they, oh, that's not what I wanted. Okay, she's gonna need her bouquet, I think. Have to go back like that. They usually have some. Brides usually have some bangy stuff going on in front, don't they? Let's give her a little bit of bang. And a little bit of detail before we get to the Oh, you know, if you notice that I haven't switched back to the right screen, you should let me know. He's got too much of a chin, doesn't he? Pull his chin back a little bit. Round the nose off, shorten it a bit. So she's going to have an ear. It'll go like that. And then the veil will come around flowers. And then they almost always have low cut fronts, don't they? Little pearls. That. Trump's hair can have a little bit of extra swoosh going that way. Veil stuff can happen on top of her head as well. What do these boutonnieres look like? They look like some little rosy things. With a little bit of frilly goop. And then hers are little rosy things with frilly goop. And she needs to hold it like with her human hand. Wanted to get closer on their faces in this one. So her trunk could go a little farther. Let's go with that. And now let's reposition the speech balloon. The width I've got going here. I think the balloon needs to come up higher. Women always cry at weddings. Fluff over here. I'm going to bring Trump up on the screen, make sure I get his face looking right. So let's... see if things are working here again. For some reason, Google and Yahoo are not working for me today. But Bing works. Odd. I usually prefer Google Images to Trump, but I should, pretty much the same images as on Google, huh? This is what I'm looking at on my screen in front of me, as I'm going to need to get a little bit better Trump, although my Trump's not looking too bad. He needs more floof to the back of the head. Now, maybe you should have a little smile. He has an alternative face. And Trump's alternative face is this big, wide smile, which... looks like that. And I don't think I want that. I like his little pouty mouth. All right, let's go with the pouty mouth. I think I've got this going. Let's squish that up a little that way. Trump is gonna need to come down to here, huh? Try to think of it down at that level. I might want to raise her bouquet up over here. So I'll think about that. Something I need to think about at the beginning. I may drop the bouquet. It makes more sense without it. Makes the bottom go flatter. Alright. There shall be no bouquet. Boutonniere on Trump is all that's going to happen in the way of floral arrangements for this puppy. Here quite a while drawing this one. So, in case you're wondering, this is my cup full of pencils, all sharpened and ready to go. It's my flint water. I'm going to switch back to bride and groom here, because I'm going to start with the elephant. And the elephant needs to be very much crying. She is a bride. She needs her makeup. She should be an attractive elephant bride. Okay. There's a lot of variety in bridal hairstyles that I must say I have never considered. The alternative cartoon to this was going to be a wedding night with Trump and the elephant, crying elephant, and both smoking cigarettes. But I went with the wedding picture because I think wedding picture, when anything you can do with a wedding is always stronger. Tears welling up in the eyes. I think the veil needs a little extra attention. So, Akomi, I've only got two people watching now. Are you one of them? Did I lose you, David? I can hide her ear. These veil wrinkles are, I need to be more thoughtful about those. Veil wrinkles. trying to think of which way this crazy veil stuff would go. So it's not necessarily clear. Yeah, I've been off for about a week working on business stuff. And I didn't want a week to go by without a cartoon. So that's where we are today. Today's cartoon is belated. Lock on 5500. Nice to see you here. I think I'm down to only one viewer, and that would be you. So nice to have you here, Lock on. I see you followed me 9 days ago. That's great. Comey, you're right. Stream is not working. Can you try streaming in a lower definition? I'm looking over here to my right at my screen that shows the stream, and I'm not seeing any problem. I'm not even seeing much lag. It's actually looking pretty good. So I think the problem's on your end. Sorry about that, Comey. Also, it shows one person watching, but here I am chatting with both you and Lock On 5500. So there's got to be more than one person watching. It doesn't make any sense. Lipstick. Good for you, Lock On. Yeah, sorry about that, Akomi. It's looking good for me as well. In her mouth. Hey, three people watching. Well, it's quiet today. The lipstick will make that fun for color. Adjust my chroma key here. It suddenly got darker outside. I think it's gonna rain. And that makes my lighting change. That should go straight down and correspond with that. I'm not too happy with those tears, so let's rethink the tears and the veil on this side. Let's give her a little more eyeliner, because she is a bride, and I find that brides wear lots of eyeliner. You want her lipstick smeared, huh? Okay. I'm gonna go with the pearls now. A little bit of some shadow under the pearls. That pearl needs a fix. Let's have her chest come out a little bit over here. Lots of low-cut bridal gowns here. She's gonna need her shoulder defined under here. That looks terrible. I haven't been putting enough thought into my veil wrinkles. So let's get rid of these. It's not a scarf. I'm drawing it like it's a scarf. Not a scarf. Pink erasers on the end of pencils. More assertive erasing. I'm going to give her a little bit of volume cross-hatching. put in some little glowy, poppy sparklies. Bring cry down to the next line. Oh well. Cry. Out. He can have a little bigger boutonniere, I guess. I'm gonna finish this trunk. now that I'm drawing Trump, moving on from her, you can see this is what I'm looking at on the screen. Looks like everything's still working. All right. I've got a piece of sandpaper over here on my right, which is why I keep going like that. Trump. His eyes are not really small. I think I may have them too small. All right, let's... I think that looks okay, kinda. Not the best looking Trump, but I've seen worse. Oh, the chin. This eye is a little too wide. The other eye is looking good. of it needs to be kind of at half-mast. And wider on the outer side than on the inner side. Yeah, not many people watching and not a lot of conversation today. Makes it a little hard to keep talking. All right, let's give her a little bit of tears here. Sure, what goes on with these collars? Men's collars at weddings. Kumiliotti writes, "You, sir, are a legend in my eyes, and I'm so happy that I'm able to watch you do your art live." Well, boy, I love those kind words, Kumiliotti. and I need for you to follow very much need the follows. Okay, he gets these little things like that on his tuxedo shirt, right? A little bit of confusion there with the elephant trunk. But that's where I wanted her trunk to go. Alright. So, yes, thank you so much, Kumuliotti. Not a lot of people watching today. Quite the quiet afternoon. Busy news day. The scotch tape underneath there. Ah, Kumuliotti, you did follow. You must have followed a while ago. Where else might follow? Oh, I've got a. There you're showing up as following. Not in the second window. Well, thank you. How often do I draw live? I'm doing all my cartoons live, and I usually draw two or three cartoons a week, although this week, this is my only cartoon, because, you know, I also wear a second hat as the head of a little cartoon syndicate. And I had a bunch of work to do at the end of month royalties for the artists, and I'm working on some coloring books. Wanna see? Here's one of the coloring books. Hillary Clinton coloring book. And I think they're fun. My cartoons, I think, work well with coloring books. You get the idea in here. It's this is the cartoon I drew last week. So, coloring books. I think they're fun. See what happens with them. I'm doing four. I'm doing Trump, Obama, Hillary, and Wall Street. And I do need to get this cartoon into the Trump book because I don't have enough Trump. Lock on 5500. His a cartoon base. I'll take your word for that. Here's a cartoon base. Anyway, I like the coloring books. Here's a cartoon boss. Here's a cartoon boss. Giving him a boutonniere with little roses in it. hilarious. Yeah, maybe my Hillary book is hilarious. You got to know your Hillary. Cause here, they talked all about her in the last election. The 2008 election was all about her with being the commander-in-chief for the military. And so I took this old cartoon from 2008 and I updated some of her medals to be a little bit more current. I added Bill's speeches. I think I added the emails. Where are the emails? Did I not add the emails? I thought I added the emails. Oh, home email server. There it is. So I updated a little bit. A little bit of update. People tell me, oh, wouldn't you as a cartoonist love to have Trump as president? And I'm not sure that Trump is a better cartoon character than Hillary. Hillary is a great cartoon character. We've had her for so many years. We have so many wonderful stories about her that you all know. All those medals on her book cover. And, she's got the pantsuit. She's got some nice body language that makes for wordless cartoons. That is all good. All for the good. So this is his boutonniere. A couple tears over here. Not that the tears would go over there, but I had a space for them, so we'll say they did. I don't like having a flat black, so I do want to have some evidence of my hand going on in here. Kumuluati writes, I'm interested to see the news from all over the world, even though I'm from Finland myself, but I like to keep myself updated and have to say that your cartoon is one of my ways to keep me updated. Well, very good. Keep you updated. Of course, I haven't drawn for the last week, so you're not getting too much world news from my cartoons. Come on, tape. Come off of there. Goodness. Tape is resistant today. I want to draw on that spot. Friggin' tape. I think I'm going to need to sign it here on her upper arm. Trump's hair. I know cartoonists love drawing Trump's hair, and I kind of struggle with it because I think of Trump's hair as being like this soft little cloud that floats in front of his forehead, but I have to depict that with lines. And aren't necessarily the best way to depict a soft, fluffy little cloud. All right, soft, fluffy little cloud. Thank you. soft and fluffy little cloud of hair. Oopsie, I drew a line that was too dark because it's got to be soft and fluffy. I can't have anything that's too dark because he is soft and fluffy. Sides of his head, the hair is not so soft and fluffy. He's got his hairspray going on the sides. Let's get his ear in there. Needs to come out a little bit. Oh, you like my Trump hair flow, Cumulati? Thank you. Hey, Bear Edwards, nice to see you back. Not sure I like his little tail here. I guess it's okay. Not sure I like it, but I guess it's okay. That year either. I'll start that over. Years have an interesting structure. One of these days, I might do an year video. But not today. Nice to see you here, Bear Edwards. Yeah, you know, I think I might just redo all of this foxtail here. The problem was that it needed to be a little thicker. Oh, you like this one, huh, Bear Edwards? I'm not real happy with this spot here. Need a little more thought on that. I think this needs to come over a little bit as well. So, the back of his head. Is okay now. I say as I just screw it up. All right, I'm going to redo the back of his head. Right here behind the ear. That's what the eraser is for. I was originally, Bear Edwards, going to have him say, "The women always cry at weddings." And I showed it around to wife and family, and they did not think that it should say, "The women always cry at weddings." I thought that was funnier. But other people just found it disturbing. Okay, I think I'm gonna need some scritchy scratch background stuff going on. And in this case, it's not real easy to think of how I'm gonna do that. You know, I struggle with figuring all this stuff out for the first time. I'm not one of those formulaic cartoonists where there's a easy solution to everything. It's like I figure everything out from scratch each time. That's running over a ridge of piece of paper that I put underneath, which is why I'm having trouble with that spot. There's no bottom of the nose could be darker. I like to take places that are showing up against the light source and make the lines that are on the shade side a little thicker. Like that. Okay, what can we do with some background stuff? Do it with tone, but I don't really want to do tone right now. Whew. See that I'm up on the screen here. I'm looking at Donald Trump, which is how I keep him in mind. His eyes are kind of small, aren't they? All right, now it needs some swooshy background stuff going on that I'm going to need to rethink. Thank you. I shouldn't use a Chipotle napkin. I need a regular piece of paper. That's to keep my hand from smearing the pencil. Okay, now I need to sign it somewhere. So let's go with on her upper arm. Now my timer isn't working now, so I'm going to need to go off for a bit and come back on when I have the scan of this to color. That may be too much ear detail. You know, when a drawing seems like it's going to be simpler, and you got two big heads, it usually makes for a stronger cartoon, but it's harder to get the details right. All right, I think I'm just about done here. I will, I will scan this thing and come back and color it pretty quickly. That is it. Okay, this is, let's see whether I think a few more veil lines are good here in her mouth. Kind of disturbing to the mouth, but it kind of looked like it needed something on the veil to make it look right. Same with her lipstick. So that's going to be it for here, and I will, I'm going to sign off for a little bit, and then I will come back and do the color. So don't lose me. I shall return. I don't have the timer going now, but hey, I'm still here. I will return. Thank you much, and don't go away even though the stream stops. Thanks. And that's the end of the drawing stream. I will come back and do the color in just a few minutes. Thank you much, folks.